leading to the wedding of Akshaya and Hari in 2012. It's not for nothing, they say, marriages are made in heaven. We shall now take you through some of the rituals of a Hindu marriage. Yatra. This is a ritual where the groom wears a new pair of sandals and then proceeds for Kasi Yatra holding an umbrella and a walking stick, intending to renounce worldly life. At that time, the father of the bride intercepts him, offers his daughter's hand in marriage, and convinces him and brings him back to Grihastashrama. Exchange of garlands. In this ritual, garlands are exchanged between the bride and the groom. During this ritual, the boy and the girl are physically lifted and held by their respective uncles. This ceremony adds a lot of fun and festivity to the marriage function. This is the swing ceremony. During this ceremony, the bride and the groom are made to sit on a swing. The female relatives of both the parties sing classical Carnatic music songs. The singing brings about a sense of bonhomie between the families of the bride and the groom. The swing is supposed to signify the ups and downs of life, and both the bride and the groom facing the obstacles, meaning the ups and downs of life, staying together. Mangalya Dharanam. This is the most precious moment in one's life. During this ceremony, the bride sits on her father's lap and the groom ties the Mangalya Sutra, meaning the sacred thread, around the bride's neck, chanting prayers for their well-being and to live for 100 years. Saptapati. During this ritual, the groom holds the bride's right hand and walks 7 steps. This is the most important part of the marriage ceremony. Only when the bride and groom walk these 7 steps, meaning Saptapati, is the marriage considered as legal. This also indicates that when the couple walks 7 steps, they become friends with each other. The mantras recited while taking the 7 steps mean, "Yea, who has walked 7 steps with me has become my companion, and I acquire your friendship. Henceforth, we shall remain together and inseparable. Let us take a vow that we will share love, share the same food, the same tastes, share our strengths. We shall live as one mind and uphold the true values of the vows together. I shall be the upper world, you be the earth. I shall be the Sukhilam, you the holder. Together we shall live, beget children and other riches. Come thou, O sweet-minded girl." Pani Grahanam. During this ritual, the groom holds the bride's right hand and recites marriage vows in 4 mantras. While chanting the mantras, the groom offers prayers to Agni, the god of fire, Saraswati, the goddess of knowledge, and Vayu, the lord of wind, seeking blessings for a long life and congruence of mind. There is a ritual that follows after the Saptapati during the late afternoon or evening. It is called as Nelangu. The newlywed wife calls her husband for playing by singing a song. They both are surrounded by their families and friends. This is followed by a list of playful customs such as the bridegroom anointing the bride's feet with colorful paste and vice versa. the bride fans him and shows him a mirror. Then, the bride and the groom break papad over each other's heads. Subsequently, a betel pack is wrenched from each other's hands. Then, they start rolling the coconut from one to the other as in ball play and so on. During this ritual, the female members sing songs while all these are happening and make fun of both the bride and the groom in a lighter way. These bring out many qualities of both the bride and the groom, namely the sporting spirit, kindness, love, strength, cooperative nature, and so on. This ceremony also builds up a physical closeness between the bride and the groom, eventually preparing them for consummation of their marriage.